Let me teach you how to assemble a lithium accumulator for any amperage and voltage. No matter what kind of device you connect then, it may be a scooter, a bicycle, a screwdriver or a solar panel, or maybe a powerful external battery. You know that I always use simple lithium cells. They're 18650 Samsung. I buy them 1.5 USD per one. I've been using them for a long time. They prove their reliability even in severe winter. These cells are all in the snow. We have even filmed some crash tests with them. And the cells have passed through it honorably. The company made nice goods, so they won't explode for no reason. Possibly the main thing to know is how to make these cells keep the voltage you need. In fact, it's quite simple. Using the consecutive connection, each new cell adds up some more voltage. So if I use one cell, I will have 3.6 volts. That is an average cell voltage. If I add one more, I will get 7.2 volts already. And so on. We can solder together 3, 4 or 100, it doesn't matter. What means to solder consequently? That's easy peasy, just connect one after another, it's like a tube flash. Like this, one by one. And we solder the positive plate of the first cell to the negative plate of another cell, then we solder the positive end of the second cell to the negative plate of the first cell, and so on, about any quantity. If we need 36 volts, we connect 10 cells together. If you need 48 volts, you're gonna need 13 cells. Someone may need 12 volts for a screwdriver, for example, so he needs 3 cells. Just have a look at this battery. You can clearly see that the negative plate is soldered to the positive plate, and it's made in a kind of zigzag, one after another, in a row. There are 14. Alright, we've got the voltage we needed, and what about the capacity of these batteries? This one cell has 2600 mAh. If you want more, we can double the capacity using 2 cells, connected in parallel. Thusly, we are getting 5200 mAh, and we've increased the capacity. Let's stop talking and let's move to the actions. I recommend you a very practical thing, these plastic clamp things. You know, they are just like the Lego cubes.
Opa!
The red are for the positive clamps and the negatives are black. Let's make the bases and just put inside the cells correctly. Then I put the plastic clamps on the top. Look at this little beauty. It's 12 volts and about 5000 ampere hours. That's right what I need for a screwdriver. Just take a pile of cells, my favorite explosives. As simple as that, negative bottom in the black, positive plate on the red. I told them it's just like Lego. Right. I feel joy sounding that, you know? Till this line it was for 36 volts, but now we're expanding it, adding more cells. Right what I need for an e-bike. They're 84, and it's 4 kilos and 113 grams. You know, it isn't that heavy for this insane capacity. You can also use some hot glue to fasten them. It's reliable, but not that cute. There are two ways to connect the cells in this accumulator. It's contact welding and soldering. I use soldering because it's relatively simple. And if you try hard, you can make it very nicely in no time. Important, do not overheat the cells. If you're going to use welding, you should know that welding isn't that simple as you may think about it. You're going to spoil numbers of cells before you realize how to do it properly. The soldering iron should be solid to make the process quick and easy. So, you will have the contact heated well and fast. If your soldering iron is thin, you will heat the contacts very slowly, and the accumulator will be overheated and may be spoiled. You can also use some soldering acid instead of rosin. Thus, you will make the tin melt faster. But be careful. You need only a small drop of soldering acid. Don't let it touch the isolation. The tin wire should be thick enough to cope with the current of a single cell. That's around 5 amperes. But not too thick, because it can serve as a thermal fuse when a short circuit. Look at the result of our hard work. Let's solder the balancer output to it. Now is the time for the most frequently asked question. How to attach the balancer and protection board? I warn you, do not use lithium with no protection board. It will die soon and may burn up while charging. The balancer must use the battery voltage perfectly. And don't be afraid to pick a bigger limit of the maximum overcharge it can cope with. The maximum my e-bike can need is 17 amperes, but I take the balancer board for 45 amperes, because the Chinese tend to overrate the parameters. Let's connect the protection board first. We need to take the negative wire from the accumulator we have assembled, cut it and solder to the protection board. Take the first part of the wire and solder it to the B minus. Take the wire from the consumer to the charger and solder it to C minus. This is it. The accumulator will not explode now. I can sleep well at least. After this, we are going to connect the wires to the balancer. This means that the current will be distributed to the cells equally. The first wire in the bunch is usually black. We need to attach it to the negative of the battery. The second wire goes to the positive plate of the first cell in the accumulator. The third wire goes to the second cell and so on till the end. You will not mess this up because the assembly instruction is always in the set or in a site. That Chinese factory has sent me an insane number of cells. But why do I need so many cells? That's easy. Kreosan team is going to the scientific expedition. We are going to ride our e-bikes really far away. Today we have made three powerful accumulators. And tomorrow we are going to cover over 1,000 kilometers to see the Black Sea. And now let me teach you how to turn this accumulator into an extremely powerful power bank. And all we need is just to solder a 220 socket. And that's it. I have learned from my own experience that the most of the devices working on 220 volts are easily compatible with 48 volts. This works because today's devices are usually multi-standard. I mean they are created to suit different voltage standards of countries. The capacity of this accumulator is 1000 times bigger than the usual ones, so the laptop may work an entire week on it, and it won't even spend all the energy. Right now we've got the accumulator that equals the gasoline motor in power for each e-bike. This voltage is relatively safe for people. I feel like I close the circuit, it heats up. You must be feeling some prickling. But how are we going to charge these batteries? Especially this giant one. We can order a ready-made charger cable. We can use a laboratory power supply like this one. We can set the parameters of the voltage and so on. And we also can make a charging device ourselves. There are some secrets of charging. If you want to use your accumulator longer, don't charge it to the limit. And do not discharge it to the limit. But there is the opposite way of using the charge. You can overcharge the cells to 4.3 volts. And the capacity of these accumulators will grow sufficiently. This may come in handy if you need to go a long road using one charge. Don't forget about the case, you can make it or buy one, it doesn't matter. I have decided to create a supercharger, which can charge up 3 e-bikes in a few minutes. As a base I use a compact welding inverter. I added 2 windings to its coil, to increase the voltage and so we could charge up 48 volt accumulator. I have added the condenser to remove the voltage ripple. But it turned out to be too strong. So I had to connect in parallel a few powerful condensers, and it worked. Now the welding inverter can charge 3 accumulators at once. The only drawback is, it heats too much, but the thermal protection doesn't think it is wrong. It gives out 37 amperes, and that is the minimum. During the expedition we are going to stop for some snack each 150 kilometers, and while we'll be eating, the accumulators will be charging. What do you think about it? Will this e-bike stand the heat of the desert? Steep rocky roads or maybe some storms? You will see that in the next video.